Hi, are you a cybersecurity expert who has been moved to management or has been in a team environment and is now solely responsible for cybersecurity in an organization? I have a tip that will help make your job a lot easier and a lot more effective. I'm Jordan Schroeder, and it is my passion to help business and security leaders find great leaps in success in their cybersecurity programs. If you are a cybersecurity expert, then one of the things that you're probably known for, and one of the things that you've built your career on, at least to this point, is your ability to be expert in the technical domain. And this is completely normal. This is completely expected. We need cybersecurity experts who are extremely adept in the technical realm. But when you are in management, or when you are alone in security, the technical side of things is only one part, and that's important to realize. When you're in management, or when you're alone, there are two sides to security that you now need to tackle, and that's what I want to talk about today. I'm going to talk about these two sides of cybersecurity in terms of ordered problems and unordered problems. Ordered problems are what you're used to in the technical realm. These are things where there are the right answers available. There are best practices, there are frameworks, there's technology you can put in, there's a linear relationship between cause and effect. Firewalls are great example of this. You put in a firewall to limit traffic to certain ports, and with doing that, you can prevent attacks and prevent unauthorized traffic to these ports and reduce the risk. That's normal. That's a type of an ordered problem. But when we talk about unordered problems, we're talking about something very different. We're talking about a lot of uncertainty and a lot of ambiguity. We're talking about things that can't be predicted and where there isn't this linear relationship between cause and effect. In fact, when you're dealing with risks and concerns in this area, you might not know exactly how to prevent or how to improve security in this particular area. The big example in this is security awareness. Security awareness is an unordered problem because you're dealing with people. People are not machines. People are not robots. People are not even ants. People are people. And people are going to behave in ways that might fit some patterns, but those patterns are unpredictable. You don't know what a person is going to do ahead of time. And as a security manager or a person responsible for security in the unordered domain, it's your responsibility to deal with that. And I've seen a lot of security experts just throw up your hands and say, there's nothing you can do about it. There's nothing you can do with people. If only they would stick with the process, if only they would follow the policies, we would be fine. And you wash your hands of that. And that's a very normal reaction. But that's a reaction from the ordered side. That's a reaction of someone who has been dealing with the ordered domain for most of their career in this area. The unordered domain exists. And when we're talking about humans in particular, that's 80 to 90% of the risks to an organization come from people. So if you're not addressing it, you're leaving a lot of risk on the table that's simply not being managed. So then how do you manage it? Well, again, what a lot of people want to do, and it's a natural reaction, is to try to micromanage and provide as much structure and policy and procedures and a lot of linearity to the unordered domain and to the people problem to try and shove them over into the ordered domain. This doesn't work. This really doesn't work. And what you need to be able to do is deal with the unordered domain in an unordered way. What you want to do, first off, is you want to take a look at the problems that you're running into, like security awareness or whatever other problem that you're dealing with. You want to look at the problems and see, is it in fact unordered? Is there a linear solution to this? And if there is a linear solution, then you do want to try and move it over to the ordered side of the coin. But what you'll find most of the time is that it is unordered, and you can't make it or force it to be ordered, like when you're dealing with how people operate. In order to manage the unordered, this requires not the right answer, not the best answer, not best practice. This requires experimentation. This requires innovation. This requires finding solutions that are going to work here and now, and they might work in the near future, but there's no expectation that they're going to work next year. They're things that are going to work now. And as the situation evolves, you might find you need brand new solutions. And that's part of being a cybersecurity manager. That's part of being in charge of security. You've got the ordered problems, which are cool and they're easy to solve, and we feel good when we can put the solutions in place to solve them. But the unordered domain also exists, and that's what we're called to do too. We need to address these problems. So the tip that I have is to let go of your notions that all problems need to be ordered, and every security problem needs to be an ordered solution. Security awareness is one of these things. You have no idea whether or not security awareness is going to be effective. A lot of people will say security awareness training is absolutely not effective, but that's not true. It's not effective in a linear way. It's effective in non-linear ways. And you need to understand and help recognize and deal with that. The other problem that runs into, and I've seen this in most organizations, is patching. Patching should be an ordered problem. But for 99% of the organizations I've dealt with, it becomes an unordered problem. Why? Because there's a lot of uncertainty and a lot of ambiguity in patching. Number one, you don't know whether or not the patch you're going to apply is going to bring down your server. It's a huge disruption, and you don't know if that's going to brick the server, if that happened, or whether or not it's going to be a simple 2-minute patch, you're up and running and everything's fine. You don't know. And so because organizations have a very linear ordered approach to patching, you just click the button, you schedule your maintenance window as you move on with life, they don't allow for this unordered ambiguity. And management is also not prepared for it. They get angry and grumpy and concerned whenever servers go down. But if you re-engineered your patching process, for example, to allow for that ambiguity, to say, hey, we don't know what's going to happen, right? We know we're supposed to patch, we need to patch, but we have no clue what the effect is going to be. If you bake that expectation into your patch process, then you can solve that problem. And baking ambiguity into your processes is one of the things that'll make you a far more successful cybersecurity manager or a leader in cybersecurity in general. Not all problems are ordered, and not all problems are ordered in the same way, and not all problems are unordered, and not all problems are unordered in the same way, and as the diagram shows, they don't always stay in the ordered or unordered domain. They will change and swap sides periodically. And what might be ordered for you might be unordered for someone else, and vice versa. You get better at cybersecurity management by getting better at understanding what's ordered and unordered, and learning the ways to manage ordered things in an ordered way and unordered things in an unordered way. This has been Jordan. If you have any questions on this, I realize this was pretty high level and conceptual. If you have any questions on this, feel free to post them in the discussion below. If you are wanting to dig into this concept a little bit further, you want to take a look at things called complexity management. And probably the biggest and most interesting complexity management framework I've read is what's known as the Cynefin Framework, and I'll post that link in the description field below as well, so you can do a deep dive in that. It's a very complex issue, it's very multifaceted and nuanced, but you will be better as a cybersecurity manager if you can wrap your head around some of these concepts and allow for more of this variance and ambiguity in your security program. Thank you very much.